Hey, how y'all doing?
Hey, how y'all doing?
I'm making a pledge right here, right now, to make this the best year of my life so far. This series is going to consist of 52 bucket list items that I want to complete for every week this year. Then post a vlog style video on the last day of every month for the next 12 months. Here's to the best year of my life.
Well, this is awkward. If you've been subscribed to my channel since the beginning of the year, you'll know that the very first day this year, I posted a video to which I actually said that this was going to be the best year of my life.
Here's to the best year of my life.
Fast forward 364 days later, and it wasn't.
2020, the worst year ever.
Deadly wildfires that are sweeping through Australia.
Kobe Bryant has been killed in a helicopter crash.
The urgent new coronavirus warning.
The murder hornet for its powerful sting.
Getting more violent following the death of George Floyd.
The death of Supreme Court Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg.
Speech, press, religion, assembly. I don't know, what am I missing?
Proud Boys, stand back and stand by.
A million new cases.
It was quite the opposite. So with that being said, in the first video of this year, I proposed this idea where I was going to make a bucket list video that would be posted on the last day of every single month with a compilation of bucket list items that I completed during that month. And I successfully did that the first 2 months this year, and then March came around, and I think we all know what happened in March. Originally in March, when we all went into lockdown, you know, COVID was just running rampant. Well, it still is. I was like, okay, I just will put a pause on this for this month, and then next month I'll just put both of them together and then we'll be good to go. And then April, like, it just continuously, progressively, digressively got worse. A majority of the things on my bucket list were outdoor activities, traveling activities, doing things with other people activities. 90% of the things on my bucket list got canceled due to this pandemic. Therefore, I could not do it. Now, my reasoning behind, like, not addressing this at all was just because I simply thought that it was going to get better, and it did not. And now we're on the last day of this year, so I felt like it was appropriate before 2020 is out to just, like, give you guys an update. So, realistically speaking, like, getting everything done on this bucket list, like, this year, pandemic or not, it was impossible, and I had my dreams through the roof, and all of them got crushed this entire year. So I think a lesson that I've learned this year is that you can dream big, but, like, also make it realistic, okay? Make it accomplishable. A majority of them cost a lot of money, and at the beginning of this year, I was making no money. So in a way, the pandemic has helped me because I've been able to work more and actually got promoted at my job, which I didn't want to do, but that's a different story. And then on top of that, in, like, February, I was already struggling with getting the things completed because I already had to make a weekly video, and then, like, editing this video, like, and just, like, doing all these different activities, like, it was a lot, and there wasn't a lot of time to do it. So in a way, like, I'm kind of glad that I didn't have to, I had a really big excuse to not post anymore. So yeah, the bucket list series will not be coming back in the way that I was doing it. I am still going to hold myself to this bucket list, and I'm still going to complete every item off of it. There's a lot of things on here. I am just not going to put the pressure of completing it all in 1 year, nor by a certain time frame, okay? Because posting at the end of the month, that only gave me, like, 30 days each month to get things done, and I don't like that pressure. So from now on, like, anytime during my free time, I'm gonna try working on these things, and I will post them just, like, sporadically throughout the year whenever, you know, it'll just be like a special, like, present to you guys. Also, there are a few things on this list that could have been completed during the pandemic indoors, which, like, I really did attempt to do. Like I already mentioned earlier this week in my surprising my family for Christmas video, if you haven't seen that, go click up here. I gave, like, a really long explanation of how much this year has sucked for me, and, like, a big thing that I was doing was just, like, really, like, telling myself, like, you need to do these things. Like, especially the bucket list was in the back of my head the entire time. I was like, you said that you're gonna do these things, you still can't do them, like, go do them. And, like, I just didn't have the ability to get out of bed because of everything else that was going on in my head. So it just made it really hard on me because I really wanted to do the things, and then I really just didn't want to do anything at all, and it resulted in me doing absolutely nothing. So with that, just be looking forward to the next couple of years when I'm getting these things done. Hopefully it doesn't take longer than 2 years to get everything done. Okay, is that cool with everyone? Okay, cool. Thank you for like letting me do that. I appreciate that. Thank you for not putting pressure on me, because that feels like a weight lifted off my shoulders. And that's also why I didn't address it, because I didn't want to disappoint anybody, but you got to do what you got to do. Okay, finally, now over the past 8 months, I was able to attempt to do 3 things on my bucket list, and I wish I would have completed them, but you know, life just got the best of me. One of which I actually completed and was actually probably the best day of this entire year. And it's when I went hiking to the top of a mountain, and that was something that I really wanted to do, and I could do it because there was no one around. Like, I'm just hiking by myself. So I was able to do that at the very beginning of the pandemic, and I'm happy that I was able to do it because I enjoyed it so much. And like I said, that was just one of the best memories that I've had this year. So I'm really happy that I got to complete that. So I will be putting that at the end of the video. And then also I did 2 other bucket list items that are not complete. The reason why I'm going to show them to you guys, even though they're not complete, is because the footage will be so old by the time I actually complete them that I just probably won't even use it. And I spent a lot of time trying, okay? So I want to show you guys my attempts, even though I didn't finish, but I still want you guys to see I was trying like really hard in June. Like, I had like this really big mindset where I was gonna get things done, and just things went south. They went really bad. But I am in a better headspace now, and I'm really going to try to complete these things within the coming year. So look forward to these things, guys. But without further ado, I will show you guys what I attempted to complete over the past 8 months. So I hope you guys enjoy, and have a happy new year. This will be the last time that you see me in 2020. Goodbye to this year. And I hope you guys have a great, safe, happy new year. Stay indoors, don't spread the virus. Okay, yeah, so roll the old footage. Okay, so today is probably the last day that I can do this because the weather is supposed to get like really hot after this, and today it's only gonna be up to 80, so I think it's an ideal day to do this bucket list item that I wanna do. Now, I'm going to be hiking a mountain, okay? I'm not gonna be climbing one. I know some people have climbing Mount Everest as their bucket list item, okay? I don't wanna do all that. I don't even know how to climb mountains like that. I just want to like make it to the top of a mountain by hiking it. So I thought this item was kind of dumb for a second, but then I realized I'm from Texas where it's just like super flat. Like, so I would never even get this opportunity if I didn't live out here. But then I just like look everywhere and there's just mountains everywhere here, and it's just like I'm not used to that, and I want to get to the top of one. Yeah, so I'm gonna go hike to the top. I'm pretty excited. I feel like I didn't hype this up enough, but yeah, I'm excited. And I bought this backpack, which basically like only holds water, and it has like a straw attached to it so you can like drink on the go. I'm pretty excited to use this too. Let's go. The weather outside is amazing, so I'm glad I decided to come at this time. Chose a pretty good day. I thought this was gonna be easier. My thighs are burning. I am not excited to walk back down. I made it though. Who knew that the decline was gonna be harder? I just slipped and cut myself and I fell into cactus. That was such a good experience. The weather was really nice today too. The wind was blowing the entire time. In total, it took me 4 hours. It took me 2 hours to go up and 2 hours to come down. I had to go really slow coming down because there was like loose gravel, but like I got a boo-boo. Other than that, it went smoothly. I enjoyed it a lot, and the weather was great. I'm pretty sure today's the last day I could do it because tomorrow it's gonna be 90. I just feel really great. I recommend everyone to go hike to the top. It's not easy though. My legs are gonna be dead tomorrow. I'm not sure what part of my body this is, like my leg, like I think it's my groin, like where my thigh is, but like it's so sore, and I know tomorrow I'm gonna be dead. Check on that one. Miss Rona ain't gonna stop us today. I guess because the weather was so nice yesterday or something, I didn't notice that the sun was beaming down on me the entire time. So I got a sunburn for the first time in my entire life. Do you guys see that? Like, there's a literal line right there. But it was worth it because at least I got to the top of a mountain. Okay, so some of you know I started skateboarding like maybe like 8 or 9 months ago. Not the best, not even good. I finally got down like how to ride the board. I just wanna do a kickflip. That's all I wanna do in life. Like once I do this, like I'll be complete. Yeah, so my location is this nice like, it's not a dark alley, I guess, because it's lit up, but it's still an alley. It's a little creepy. But a nice full moon going on over there, so it actually looks really well lit on the camera. It's just a little creepy over here because I'm the only one out, also because of quarantine, I guess. But and now I know this is going to take a lot of practice, so I'm not expecting to get it at all tonight, but I am just gonna keep practicing and trying it, and I wanna try and get it on film, so I'm just gonna record everything, and then I'll just stay here, I guess, until either the battery dies or the card's full, which the battery dies like in 5 minutes every time, so we'll just see how far that gets us. I need to watch a tutorial on how to do it because I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. This video didn't really help me like at all. I have 0% idea what I'm doing. Okay, I know it was gonna be hard, obviously, but I'm just not getting it at all. So he said that you should also know how to do these simpler tricks first, which I don't know how to do, so I guess I'll learn the simple tricks first. You just need to know how to ollie, which I don't even know what that is, but I guess I'll learn how to ollie first. I'm not even close to doing a kickflip at all. I can't even do an ollie. That was me trying to do an ollie. It's okay, I expected this. It's only day one. Let's try again next time, okay? I'm out here for day two, and I just spent an hour, and I made absolutely no progress. I really have no update for you guys because I suck still, but I guess I'll show you what I can do, which is nothing. That's it. That's all the progress I have for you for day two. Let's hope next time it's better, guys. Hey everyone! So I've been very limited on things that I can do because of everything that's been going on, okay? So I'm trapped inside, can't really do a lot of things on my bucket list, like literally 90% of the things on my bucket list I can't do. But there is one that requires me to have a lot of time, a lot of patience, and it's an indoor activity. So I'm excited for this one. It actually just came in the mail, so let's do a little unboxing. Okay, my dryer is being so loud, I'm so sorry. There it is. Okay. There's the headphones. This is the seat. This is empty, I think. And the keyboard. I specifically wanted one that had like a light up option. So like when you're learning, it like will light up those keys for you so y'all know where to like press. So it's like an easier way to learn. Ooh, fancy. Okay, DJ. So now I can practice without disturbing anyone around. This is so exciting. It has that new piano smell, you know? I'm so excited, I just plugged it in. Ooh. When you press the key, it lights up. Like, that's so cool. Out of like all the bucket list things that I do, this one is probably gonna be like the longest one. As in like, I'm gonna need to learn how to do it to be able to do what I want, which is play an entire song. So this is gonna take a while, so I will keep you guys updated. Today is like April 28th, I think it's about to be May. Hopefully this video will be out sometime before May is over. So I have less than a month to learn how to do it, but I think it should be fun. Okay, it took me about 45 minutes to build this stand, but I finally got it and I mounted the keyboard to it, and there's like a little chair that it comes with. You can't even see the keyboard, but I'm excited because I'm finally going to do my first lesson. I probably won't record much of it because I know it's gonna be a lot of learning, but I will update you guys anytime I progress in something or learn something. Wow. Okay, so it's been about an hour. I started off with watching tutorials on how to like play the piano, like, you know, like teaching me like what the notes were and stuff. But that was a lot, and a lot that I didn't really understand. So I just skipped over that and I went straight to learning how to play the song that I want to learn how to play, which is actually like more productive, because like once I learn how to play this song, I feel like I'll get like the hang of the piano and then I can like start to learn, you know? I've been practicing this about 45 minutes now and I got the very, very beginning part down. The song that I'm trying to learn how to play is titled Claire de Lune. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right. Claire de Lune. It's a pretty popular song. Okay, so the fingers from what I learned are labeled. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I'm going to place 5 on this key and 3 on this one. And then the same thing over here. This is gonna be 1 and 3. So it goes like, okay. Okay. So it's like this. That's it. That's all I've learned. That's how the song starts. So trust me, I'm going to practice this, and in a month I'll be able to play this. I don't know how long it's going to take, but I'm hoping less than a month. Okay, today is day number 3 of learning how to play the piano, and I just got down the very, very beginning of the song, and like, it's not a lot at all, but I am so impressed and proud of myself. Like, this is literally like, I just wanna master the entire song right now, but it's so late at night, so I don't have a lot of time. But I'm happy that I got at least this done. This is what I've learned thus far. Just that. It'll get there. I'm just extremely proud of that. Okay, stay tuned, because it will get better, I promise. I literally just finished editing the video, like everything is done, but I watched it back and I realized that I didn't give an update on this at all, and I actually progressed like a little bit during the summer, but I'm very surprised that I still remember it. So if I just like keep practicing, I know I can do better, but here's what I know so far. Okay, that's all I know, and I was in the middle. I remember very specifically, like 3 months ago, I was really in like in the process of learning the next step, and then I gave up. So I will definitely finish this and learn how to play this song. Also, I do want to mention that I started learning this song before it blew up on TikTok, okay? Because I know it's very popular on TikTok now, but I started doing this in May, and I have the receipts, okay? I will learn it this coming year, okay? And I will post a full video when I learn it. Okay, bye.